Hey, what's going on, guys? It's the Yankee Fan, and what I'm coming to you guys with today is episode number 14 of my Tim Tebow Road to the Show series here on MLB 14 The Show. Now, I haven't posted a series in a really long time, and I really didn't even realize it. I was looking back at my last videos, and it's been 3 weeks since this last Tim Tebow Road to the Show video, and I do apologize about that. I really did not expect to be gone from this series for that long, because this is one of my favorite series in this game. So let's see if we can keep this going, and I really want to just continue the series, as we already started the season off very hot. We have about 7 home runs already to start the season, and our batting average is not bad either. I believe we're batting about .290 coming into this game, so let's see if we can keep everything going. As you see, Tim Tebow will get a nice base hit right there. It's going to be an RBI single for him, and that's the stuff that we would like to see him to continue in this series and maybe even become an all-star, an MVP. You never know what's going to happen. So anyway, here comes his next at-bat as he hits that one into the left center field gap. That's going to go all the way to the wall. That's going to be a base hit, and Tim Tebow is going to get over to second base for a double, and that's the stuff that we really need to continue with Tim Tebow if we want to have any chance of becoming a playoff contending team. As you saw in the beginning of this video, this team had 9 wins, and I believe it was like 23 losses coming into this game, and that's just horrible. I mean, I know the Cubs are not good, but I really did not expect them to be this bad. I mean, there's something needs to be done, or we're not even going to win 50 games this year, so maybe Tim Tebow can take over this team, and maybe this 1-2 punch of Tim Tebow and Anthony Rizzo can help out a lot. You see, we do win this game, though, by a final score of 6-3. We go 3-for-5 on the game with an RBI and the double. That's the kind of games that we need to continue to have if we want to have any chance of getting into the playoffs. So we're into the next game now against the Arizona Diamondbacks. That's going to be off of the pitcher's leg. That's Brandon McCarthy, and that's going to end up being a base hit. But let's check on the pitcher, as it looks like he's in a lot of pain. And if you guys remember, a couple years ago, Brandon McCarthy actually took a line drive to the head, and that actually almost took his baseball career away. So he's actually going to have to be taken out of this game as well. And in real life, he's actually on the Yankees now, so it's kind of disappointing to see that, if that even happened to him in real life, because he's been pitching pretty well for the Yankees so far this year. So anyway, let's keep it going. Now we're on first base. Now Anthony Rizzo once again is up to bat. He's going to hit that one into left center field. That's going to split the outfielders and go all the way to the wall. Tim Tebow is on his way to third. He's rounding third on his way home. Here comes a throw. It's actually not going to be cut off, and that's going to be a run as Tim Tebow will score from first base there. And that's the stuff that we need to see more from the Cubs if we want to have any chance of becoming a playoff contending team. We're going to need Tim Tebow and Anthony Rizzo to really take over this team, and I'm really hoping that's going to be something that they're going to do later, maybe not this year, but in the next couple of years, because I really want to continue. I want to rebuild the Cubs, but I mean, if the Cubs are not going to win any games at all, it's going to get very frustrating, and we're going to want a trade eventually. So you see, we're 12-24 now. Let's get into this next game now against the Arizona Diamondbacks once again. That ball is going to be hit deep into left field, going back as a left fielder. He's not going to have a chance on that one. As you see, Tim Tebow, he pretty much knew that was gone as soon as he hit it, so that's going to be another home run for Tim Tebow, and it's just looking great for him so far this year. I really want to see him continue this. I really want to see him help the Cubs win more games, though. That's one thing I'm really looking for. Let's see if we can do it, though, and it looks like teams are starting to realize that he's a really great up-and-coming player, that they're going to start intentionally walking him now. I was kind of surprised that we got intentionally walked in that situation. I mean, I guess that's kind of respect for how well we've been playing so far this year. And you see, we're going to go 1-for-3 on the game with the home run and the RBI. We do win the game once again. Can we get a little bit of a hot streak going now? Can the Cubs start winning some games, and can Tebow help out a lot? We're now 13-24, so we were 9-23. We're on a little bit of a win streak right now. Can we keep it up? Let's see, though. That's going to be a ground ball. The second baseman's going to field that one and throw it on to first base. And that's not going to really help it out, but let's see if Tim Tebow can help out this team as much as possible.
And here's a cut fastball, but he turns this one around high and deep to center field. And that ball is gone.
Once again, Tim Tebow goes deep into about left center field, and he's really been hitting a lot of home runs. I expect him to be in the home run derby if he stays healthy, and that would be something pretty cool as well. As you see, another base hit right there from Tim Tebow, his third base hit of the game, as he continues to stroke really well. I mean, he's literally anything he hits is turning to gold as of right now. I want to see him continue this. I want to see the Cubs become a 500 team. That's what I was looking for. I don't know what I'm saying about 50, but a 500 team at least by the end of this year. That would be pretty. That would show that we're getting into the right direction. So I really want to see that, as Tim Tebow is going to get pegged right there. Let's take a look at this replay. That looked pretty painful. It looked like he was trying to swing, but then held it up. And he got hit right on that kneecap, and hopefully that doesn't hurt him going through in this career, in this season as well. So let's see, in his next at-bat, can he get some redemption, or is that knee starting to hurt him a little bit? He's going to hit that one pretty hard into right field, and that's going to be caught, though. So it doesn't look like the knee is too bad, but again, I don't know. I just don't want him to get injured. That's one thing that you don't want to see, especially with a star that's at this caliber or whatever. I can't even talk. Sorry about that. Bottom of the seventh inning, though, here in the next game against the Mets. We're in left field right now. That ball is going to be hit into left field. Tim Tebow, oh my goodness, I can't talk right now. He's going to miss that ball, though, go all the way to the wall. It was only a 3-0 game right now, but that runner who hit the ball is actually rounding third base. He's on his way home, and he's going to end up scoring on the play. A very, very terrible play that looked like it was going to be a routine fly ball for Tim Tebow, and it ended up being two runs for the Mets. So it's going to be 3-2 now, and that really does kill our momentum. We had some momentum going into this game with our win streak. Hopefully that doesn't hurt it, though. Let's see if we can rebound, though. We're in the left field once again. Bottom of the 12th inning. 4-4 is the score. That's going to be a lined or fly ball into left field. Tim Tebow is going to settle underneath that one. But once again, he's going to miss that one. What is going on with Tim Tebow? Is he getting tired? I know it's the 12th inning, but he's got to focus right now. He's missed two fly balls in this game. They're pretty easy ones. I don't know what's going on with Tim Tebow right now, but he's got to step it up big time coming up. Maybe if he can get another at bat in here. Or are we going to lose this game? I don't know what's going on, but just take a look at this. I don't know what's going on. I have a lot of problems catching fly balls for some reason in left field, and it seems that it just continues. So here comes Tim Tebow in the same game. Can he rebound, and can he help out this team? 4-4 is the score still. Top of the 13th inning. Here comes the pitch. That ball is going to be hit deep into center field. Going back is the center fielder. He's on the track. He leaps. That's going to be off of the wall. That's going to bounce away off the carom. That's going to go away from the left fielder now, and Tim Tebow's rounding third. He's on his way home. Here comes the throw. It's going to be not in time. It's going to be an inside the park home run for Tim Tebow. What a way to get out of that and really get out of that slump in left field. Try to forget about that. Make the fans forget about the two missed balls in left field. Get yourself an inside the park home run. Give them the lead in extra innings. That's exactly what we want, but we're in left field once again. Here comes another fly ball to Tim Tebow. Can he catch this one to end this game? He will settle underneath this one, and he will make that catch, and the Cubs are going to continue their win streak, and they win this game against the Mets in the 13th inning. What a game right there. Tim Tebow really came through in the clutch when they really needed him. Let's see if he can continue that now. Pinch hitting in Miami. Top of the ninth inning. The Cubs do lead this one 4-2. Here comes the pitch. That ball is going to be hit deep into right field. Going back is Giancarlo Stanton. He's on the track. He leaps. That's going to get out of here, though. It's going to be a two-run home run for Tim Tebow as he continues to hit some home runs. And this guy cannot be stopped as of right now. And I'm liking what I'm seeing from him so far. As we take a look at this replay and see how close Stanton really did come to coming down with this ball, because it looked like that one was pretty far out of there, but it looked like he still had a chance on it, and he just missed that one. So we're going to now go into the next series against the Colorado Rockies. That ball is hit deep into right field. There goes the center fielder. He will settle underneath that one right at the warning track and make the catch. So unfortunately, sometimes you are going to just miss some balls, and that's exactly what happened right there in the top of the seventh inning. So, I mean, we never know. You always get another at-bat. You can try to get some redemption. Top of this ninth inning now. Here comes the pitch, and there it is right there. Tim Tebow is going to try to get some redemption. Here comes the pitch, and that looks like it's going to just get over the wall. A home run for Tim Tebow. His last time up, he just missed one. He made sure he didn't miss it this time. It's going to be another home run for Tim Tebow, and that is going to be the end of this episode. I really hope that you guys did enjoy it. As you see right here, we're going to take a look at our stats for this game. As we went 2-for-2 on the game with one home run and two RBIs, we would win the game 7-1. The Cubs are starting to heat up. Can we keep it up in the next episode? Hopefully we do. I really want to see this team at least get to a 500 by the end of the season, and maybe next year we can get into the postseason. You never know. Maybe we can even get into it this year. Hopefully you guys did enjoy the video, though. If you did, make sure you drop a like. Again, as you guys know, I am on vacation at the moment, so this video was recorded in advance to me going on vacation. So anyway, if there's anything that you guys want to let me know in the comments down below, let me know. I'll try to reply to you guys. I'll see you guys in the next video, though. Hopefully you enjoyed. Have a good day, guys. Peace.